In this screencast, we're going to go through an example dealing with one of the heuristics of process design, that specifically of when we're needing to decrease the pressure in a process. There are a number of rules of thumb to follow when needing to decrease the pressure, especially whether or not it's a gas or a liquid. We're going to look at two in particular, that of 40 and 41 from the Cedar textbook on product and process design principles. Now, heuristic 40 states that we would consider the use of an expander for reducing the pressure of a gas, or in the case of a liquid, we would use a pressure recovery turbine, but only if we can get 20 horsepower out for the expander or 150 horsepower out for the pressure recovery turbine. Heuristic 41 specifically deals with the estimated theoretical adiabatic horsepower that we could get from reducing the pressure of a gas. And heuristic 42, which isn't shown here, is a relationship for determining the same thing for a liquid. So let's take a look at the example. In a certain process, we have nitrogen gas at 90 psi A absolute and 25 degrees Celsius flowing at a flow rate of 230 standard cubic feet a minute. Now it's to be vented to the atmosphere. So obviously there's a huge pressure reduction from 90 psi to that of atmosphere. And we're interested in using both heuristic 40 and 41 to determine whether or not an expander should be put in place or a simple valve. We're given information as to the ratio of the heat capacities and a reminder that we should be using absolute temperature. Now what's not given and something you'd have to look up is some information regarding the equation that you see in heuristic 41. The SCFM is the standard cubic feet per minute flow rate. We're told that the theoretical adiabatic horsepower is THP, so that's going to have units of horsepower. T1 needs to be an absolute temperature, and one hint here is that we're working with feet, so likely an English system, so we're going to use degrees Rankine. Lastly is this A term that you see here, and A is a ratio of the gas heat capacity ratio as seen here, where K, the gas heat capacity ratio, is given down here. So that's pretty much all the information that is needed for this problem, and we could move forward and calculate the theoretical adiabatic horsepower. First things first, we'll calculate our A value since it's used in two places in our equation. And this is just going to be K minus 1 over K, otherwise 1.4 minus 1 over 1.4, and this gives us 0.286. Now our temperature is given in 25 degrees Celsius. We need to convert this to Rankine, 537 degrees Rankine. So we take our equations and we plug in the values given in the statement and what we've just calculated, we should get the following. This gives us an answer of about 21.5 horsepower. So what's this mean? Well, we're working with gases, so let's look at our heuristic. If we can recover more than a theoretical load of 20 horsepower, then we should use or consider using an expander. Since we're at 21.5, then yes, consider using an expander to recover this energy. Remember, this is for gases only. We could also calculate the theoretical temperature coming out of the expander. This is in a previous heuristic, number 35, which shows us that the outgoing temperature is related to the incoming temperature and the change in pressure. So we've already calculated this value on the right in our above equation. We can multiply that by the 537, and we get a T2 equaling 320 degrees Rankine, which is also equivalent to negative 140 degrees Fahrenheit. So remember, these are estimates based on heuristics for process design. Hopefully this gives you an idea of how to use two in particular when we are looking at expanding a gas or a liquid.